her, she was at the tennis center. She was very attractive, very pretty. She's very nice. She's always had a great smile. She exudes fun slash joy. And I don't know, I just like, I liked that she seemed like a very happy person. And so I was like, I want to go get to know her.
Started a club team, and his best friend Jason,
the best man,
he was one of the only guys to come out to my first meeting for the club team, and he said, "Yeah, I think I got a group of guys that can do this, and they can play," and so he dragged Aubrey along, and he didn't really want to participate.
First saw her, she was at the tennis center, and she had a Packers t-shirt on, and I remember noticing that, and I was like, oh, she's a big football person.
The first time I really talked to Aubrey was probably at the tennis tournament. Like, I was briefly introduced to him by Jason at the club meeting, and then when I went to watch them play tennis, he seems surprised, and the first thing I noticed, which is the first thing everyone notices, is his piercing blue eyes.
Aubrey, can you believe today is finally here? I've been waiting so long to call you my husband, and I can't wait to be married. We have so much to look forward to in our life. You've been my friend, my confidant, and my partner, and I can't wait to share the rest of our lives together. I'm a better person and mother because of you. I love watching you with Lexi and the father you've become. Oh, she knows how to get my strings. We are so blessed to have you. Love you more than the world, and enjoy today. Love, Ashley. Hands down. I was playing in a tennis tournament, and Jason and I had a plan to invite Ashley to come watch us so I could meet her. Because I had talked to her and she's like in the club and stuff, but this would be like I'd get to meet her one-on-one. And Jason invited her out to come watch us play tennis, and she came.
Like, I was briefly introduced to him by Jason at the club meeting, and then when I went to watch them play tennis, he seemed surprised. Pursuing me, and I was a little oblivious to it for a while, but it's my roommate Becca that said, Ashley, he likes you. I was like, why does he want to walk me to class all the time? And why does he want to go do this? Or he did everything.
So yeah, I was definitely chasing her.
If I asked him to do that now, I don't know if he'd do it.
He warmed me up too. I was kind of stressed out because I was like, is she a nice girl? I was like, there's probably other nicer guys pursuing her. But I'm a very persistent person, so
yes.
I knew if I just stuck around and let her get to know me, maybe she'd hang out with me.
Until Becca, my roommate, told me, and then I said, oh, so I kept agreeing to go to class or watch a movie, whatever it was, and I knew it was headed that way. So it was exciting. It was definitely an exciting time of life. It was after spring break. I had gotten back early for some reason, and we'd been like texting and calling all week. We'd been, apart on break. And I said, let's go to Village Inn. You gotta try the quesadillas there.
That was really my first date. Thank you. movies that night. That's kind of when that happened.
Yes, that's when the movie. Batman, and we got into watching I Love Lucy, and we stayed up until like 2 in the morning watching I Love Lucy, cracking up at it. Becca told me to let the guy know that you like him back. You know, if you're around the couch, then go ahead and put your head on his shoulder. So that was my move.
It worked.
He took it from there.
We were walking there together, and I tried to hold her hand, and she went away.
Took off from there.
Kind of was the affirmation. was no official, like, going out on dates or anything. I've never really been a dating someone kind of person. I like to get to know someone, a friend, you know.
That's
kind of the approach I took.
Especially early on in our relationship, it was building a friendship.
Also a little impatient. I was ready for something to happen. So I was more excited about the moment.
I was a little nervous. It was exciting though. Like that anxious excitement, I guess. I was curious to see where it was gonna go and I was excited for it. But yeah, a little nervous. And that was the first wedding we'd gone to together. The whole weekend I wanted to tell him, and I chickened out. So I wrote him a letter and mailed it from camp, and I said, I just want you to know I love you, and I chickened out to tell you before. And then he called me right away, and he said, you didn't need to write a letter. You could have just told me. Probably walking her home from class or something. I just know then that's what I wanted. Thank you. after we got together, he asked me about other guys, and I said, "You're my first boyfriend." And he was really surprised. Always been kind of like a cheerleader, big sister to me, and guiding me through things. She's like, "Ashley, get a clue."
She's got street smarts.
She does.
She's your street smarts. We've always known we wanted to have each other. We talked about getting engaged. One moment we had was she found the perfect ring, you know, and she knew that's what she wanted. I mean, and it happened right away. I knew, like, I'm gonna get it soon, and I'm going to ask her.
So I was at work, and he had messaged me and told me to meet him out in Fountain Hills, which is where we were living at the time, at the fountain at 5:30. He was very specific. I needed to be there. And so I went out there after work, and he was standing right next to the fountain in the grass. I kind of had to walk across the grass, like bachelorette style, to get to him, and he had this very nice little speech prepared. Thank you. Really excited.
Nice to meet you.
Very nice.